Hello everyone, this is Dr. Anuja Singh and today we are going to perform electrical chemistry lab and our today's experiment is the titration using external indicator. So here we are using ferrous ammonium sulfate and we are titrating it against potassium chromate solution using the external indicator potassium ferricyanide. So what is the principle behind this titration is we are taking the acidified potassium dichromate, and when potassium dichromate react with the acid H2SO4, the three atoms of oxygen used to release. Then when we are titrating it against the ferrous ammonium sulfate, so the ferrous will convert into the ferric. So what is the reaction? Ferrous ammonium sulfate plus H2SO4 plus your potassium dichromate gives the sulfate of all the metals such as ferric sulfate, ammonium sulfate, chromium sulfate and gives water. So what happens when the ferric is oxidizing to the ferric atom? So the ferrous will make the complex with the external indicator and gives you the blue color. But when it fully converted into the ferric ions, it do not form the complex and will get the colorless. So colorless solution shows your endpoint. So now we'll start the demonstration of this experiment. So as you can see, this is the burette. This is the burette holder, funnel and conical glass, pipette. And we have this polyethylene disc for the external indicator. And we have this external indicator. This is simply water. This is the ferrous ammonium sulfate. And this is your potassium chromate solution. This one is colored. So we are titrating the ferrous ammonium sulfate against potassium dichromate. So what we do, we used to take potassium dichromate in the burette. So like this we can fill. Before that, make sure that your knob is closed properly. So simply we are transferring the potassium chromate solution into the burette. Suppose, so we have to fill this till the zero mark for the burette. So this burette is of 50 ml with the minimum it can record of 0.1 ml. So as if you cross this zero reading, we can just take it out from here and maintain at zero. So as it is colored solution, we have to record the upper meniscus. Also make sure that this is at your eye level because there will be convex and concave problem. You can read the reading wrong maybe. So every time make sure that this you have to arrange according to your eye contact. So now this is ready. I can remove this. Then, so this is acidified. Already acid is added in this solution. So next we are taking the known solution of ferrous ammonium sulfate. Its strength is N/40 and we have to take 25 ml of this solution using the pipette. So here you can see the mark. Till here we have to pipette out the solution. Okay, so till the mark we have taken the solution and we have to transfer it in the conical glass. So do not blow it, always let it be flow through gravity. So your setup is ready now. So we have to start titrating and here we have to take our reaction mixture and external indicator here. So what we have to do, we have to start with zero and at every 1 ml we have to check for the blue color. So slowly
drop wise we have to add it and continuous shaking so that the reaction mixture will be properly mixed. So suppose I have taken 1 ml. So what happens now? The reaction is happening. Ferrocyanin converting into ferrin. So I will show you first reading. What happens? We have to take first your reaction mixture here, suppose. Then your external indicator. So as you can see, it is showing the blue color, means the complex is forming. That means we have to titrate more. So suppose I am adding more. So when we have to do first time, since we don't know the end point, we have to check at every 1 ml. But here as I know, so I will run through till 10 ml. So we have to shake it and give it proper time. We have to add drop wise only so that the reaction will happen properly. So as you can see here, light greenish bluish color is there. That means the reaction is happening or a complex formation is there. Okay, suppose I have taken till 10 ml. You can see the color here. Light greenish bluish color. Greenish color actually. So when we add with the indicator, then you will get the blue color. Suppose I have taken one drop of the reaction mixture, and every time you have to clean it with the water. Then your external indicator, potassium ferricyanide, and see, we are still getting the blue color. That means your end point is still not reached. Then again you have to add 1 ml and again check for it. So slowly 1 ml we have to add and check for the end point. So I have taken again the reaction mixture here, then wash it, then take your external indicator. See, it is again showing the blue color, means still we have not reached the end point, complex formation is there. Then again add 1 ml. Then repeat the same procedure. See, still we are getting the blue color, but not little bit lightening. Means we are about to reach the end point. So again I will add 1 ml. Shake it properly. So make sure your solution should not mix, otherwise they can get contaminated. See, so this is little bit again lightening. Your blue color is fading away. So again I'll add 1 more ml. a little, but still it is not. So in this reaction, what is happening? Your ferrous Fe2 plus is converting into the ferric solvent, that is Fe3 plus. So this experiment you have to do very patiently, at least for the first reading. So now you can see it's almost faded away. Maybe one more ml will be enough. See here. We didn't get any blue color, means this is your end point. So here if I note down the reading, it is around 20 ml. So what happens, maybe your end point lies between 19 to 20 ml. So when you do next time, what we have to do, till 18 ml we can take a one shot, and after that we have to add very drop wise and check, since this burette can record 0.1 ml. So we have to check at every 0.1 ml difference. So drop wise we have to act and change for the end point. So from next time we can get the proper reading. So like this we have to do 2-3 more readings, concordant readings, and from here we can know the strength of the potassium dichromate, that is our intermediate solution, and after that we have to take the unknown solution of ferrous ammonium sulfate and we have to titrate it against the potassium dichromate. Then we can get the strength or the normality of the unknown solution of ferrous ammonium sulfate. So this is all about the practical. Thank you.